Right now, airstrikes continue around Israel as a high-rise building housing international media outlets is targeted and destroyed.
This is News 3 Now this morning.
Good morning. It's Sunday, May 16th. I'm Gabriella Becerra. Let's check in with meteorologist Hattie McLean for your certified most accurate forecast.
And good morning, Gabrielle, and good morning to all of you. We have a little bit of fog to talk about this morning. Here's our sky camera shot behind the currents. Can't see a lot from the station. 55 degrees under cloudy skies. Winds are calm and relative humidity is near 100%. You can definitely feel the moisture in the atmosphere this morning. Dew points have risen about 20 degrees from this time yesterday. Sunset not until about quarter after 8 tonight. Take a look at the visibility map. Again, patchy fog across the area. Visibility is around 2.5 miles from Lone Rock down to Platteville, 1 mile visibility in the Dells, and less than 2 miles now in Juneau. So there is some patchy dense fog present across southern Wisconsin this morning. Yesterday we had drizzle and on and off light rain showers. We're starting off pretty quiet this morning. Can't rule out an isolated shower this afternoon, but that probability of precipitation pretty low throughout the day. So most areas are going to stay dry today. Take a look at your temperatures. Again, mid 50s this morning, 55 in Madison and Janesville. In the Dells, it's 52, but 55 still in Mineral Point and Platteville, as well as Prairie du Chien. A nice warm-up is expected. Yesterday, temperatures barely made it into the 60s. We'll already be warmer than that today by lunchtime, and we go up from there. Despite the cloud cover that we have in the forecast, temperatures should top in the low 70s later on this afternoon. It'll stay mild through the evening as well, still in the 60s at 7 p.m. A quick peek at those traffic maps now. Your first warn traffic showing you no major issues right now on any of the roads in and around Madison. Keep in mind that fog, especially through southwestern Wisconsin right now. But other than that, nothing to slow you down this morning.
Thanks, Hattie. When it comes to COVID-19 vaccinations, Dane County is first, not just in Wisconsin, in the entire United States. New data from the CDC and reporting from the Wisconsin State Journal shows among counties with at least 300,000 people, Dane County has the highest percentage of fully vaccinated residents. When it comes to counties with at least 200,000 people, Dane County is on top for people at least 65 years or older. But California's Marin County is higher overall with people at least 18 years old. Despite the high vaccination rate, Dane County's mask mandate is still in place for now. Meanwhile, mask requirements continue to fall across South Central Wisconsin. On the county level, only Dane, right there in green, is still in place. We are expecting to get new guidance next week. Rock County lifted its mandate on Friday. Here's a look at today's vaccination totals. More than 45% of people in Wisconsin are at least partially vaccinated, while 39.2% are fully protected. That's about 2.3 million people. DHS is reporting 448 new cases of the virus. Four more people have died. As it starts to get warmer outside and the school year winds down, more kids will be outside biking. That's why community groups are trying to make sure everyone rides safely. UW Health and Madison Police hosted a free bike safety event in the Allied Drive neighborhood Saturday. Experts taught kids about street safety, turn signals, and helmet fittings. Organizers say biking is good exercise and critical for emotional and physical health, but bike safety can be even more important.
This is a highly rewarding job. I mean, I love it. I just love, you know, the smile that kids get when they get their first bicycle or when they get to ride or just engage with each other in the neighborhood. It's just great to be outside too, you know, to being able to even remaining, you know, distance from each other, but still having some fun outside. And we got very blessed by the weather too.
Dream Bikes and Wheels for Winners provided bikes for the event and free bike repair on site. Check this out. A yellow-billed cuckoo bird is returning to its natural habitat after months of treatment for injuries. The Dane County Humane Society's Wildlife Center released the bird in the Cherokee Marsh this weekend. It suffered bruising and feather loss after a collision with a car last summer. The Humane Society says it raised more than $3,000 from donors to feed the bird as it was nursed back to health. We're continuing to follow the developing Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Tensions continue to intensify today after Israel bombed a house in Gaza, where a family gathered to celebrate the end of Ramadan and an office housing international media. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says Israel will continue to respond forcefully.
Israel has responded forcefully to these attacks, and we will continue to respond forcefully until the security of our people is reinstated and restored.
China has successfully landed its rover on Mars, becoming just the second country in history to have a rover on the red planet. That's according to Chinese state media. The solar-powered rover will soon be deployed from the lander for a three-month mission in search of signs of evidence of ancient life on the planet's surface. The probe was launched last July and traveled for 7 months before entering Mars orbit in February. One of the biggest Pride festivals in the U.S. will have a big change this year. When New York City Pride begins next month, police and corrections officers will not be allowed to participate. The ban will stay in place until at least 2025. Organizers say they will work with a private security firm instead. They also plan to ask NYPD to stay a block away from all events, including the annual Pride March. In a statement, the department said the idea of officers being excluded is disheartening. Right now it is 7:05, and coming up, it's a situation causing families to reconsider weekend plans. Plus, here's a live look outside. Hattie is tracking your Sunday morning forecast next.
Habitat for Humanity of Dane County continues building and bringing stability to families through homeownership. As area families experience hardships, Habitat provides a pathway to financial security and independence. Strengthen our community. Support Habitat Dane County.
For the pets you love, you gotta get down to Mal's Pet Food Warehouse, where your dollar goes to help so many pets in town. Mal's Pet Food Warehouse. We raise money for farm animals in need and our friends living in the zoo. We feed rescue dogs and shelter cats and police canines too. Mal's Pet Food Warehouse powers them all.
And don't forget your free Mal's candy bar.
Chevy is America's fastest growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy and get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 Chevy SUV models, or get a $4,000 cash allowance on all 2021 Silverado 1500 True Cab pickups.
How does it feel to have an Angie home? Like savoring a midnight snack in your newly renovated dream kitchen. Get $20 off your first home project at Angie.com today. Make your home an Angie home. Angie, and done.
This is Connie Ryan of Ryan Funeral Homes. While things have changed, it's still necessary for families to stay connected. And when it comes to the loss of a loved one, it's important to process and grieve and honor your loved one in a way that keeps everyone safe. We're doing this through intimate services and private virtual streaming so your family can be part of the service no matter where they are. Ryan Funeral Homes are here with your safety in mind and compassionate care in your time of need.
Do you take daily prescription pain medications, but they don't help enough? Do you want more options to better manage chronic pain? University of Wisconsin-Madison STAMP study offers free, safe, therapeutic programs to address chronic pain. The programs occur once a week for 8 weeks and pays up to $340. Call 608-212-6902 today. Again, that's 608-212-6902.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Brisky's World.
It keeps getting better here.
With natural wild-caught tuna. It's new Frisky's Wild Favorites.
Frisky's Farm Favorites with real farm-raised chicken.
Delicious for real.
Beat their fantasy.
Frisky's.
And 7:08 this morning, we're talking a little bit about rain or lack thereof here across southern Wisconsin. Yesterday, we picked up just shy of a tenth of an inch officially in Madison. Normal by this date in the year, we've had nearly 11 inches of moisture. This year, we're well behind that, less than 6 inches so far this year. So that puts us about 5 inches below where we should be. There's definitely a rain deficit and a drought here across southern Wisconsin. Here's a look at the places that actually got measurable rain yesterday. pretty spotty across the region, about a quarter of an inch north, northeast of the Dells, a little bit west of Madison, and then down towards Janesville and Watertown. But otherwise, just drizzle and low clouds yesterday across southern Wisconsin. Now, we start this morning with a pretty quiet look on the radar map. I'll zoom it out, and you can see that across Minnesota and Iowa. Things pretty quiet. You have to get well into the plains to see any precipitation this morning. Also to our east, some showers, but again, those are moving away from us. So outside of an isolated shower popping up this afternoon, it's going to stay pretty dry. Good news on the horizon, though. We may be transitioning into a wetter period as we head through the end of May. The CPC 8 to 14 day precipitation outlook is indicating a chance for above normal precipitation across Wisconsin and much of the midsection of the country. And we definitely need the rain. So what does that look like for us going forward? Well, again, slight chances today and really to start the week. Better chances midweek as a warm front begins to move into the area. I think we'll definitely see some scattered showers and thunderstorms building in late Tuesday through Thursday. Then just slight chances as we head into the upcoming weekend. We're starting this morning. A lot of green on the map, but that's because temperatures are in the 50s. No rain right now. 55 in Madison, 52 in the Dells, 55 in Janesville. Monroe and Lone Rock, you're starting at 54 degrees. Here's a look at your future track forecast model. It shows you that the clouds try to break up a little bit, but they're not going to have a lot of luck today. Temperatures, though, will climb even despite that cloud cover. By lunchtime, you're looking at mid-60s across the area. Through the afternoon, mostly cloudy skies. There's that slight chance for a shower here and there. Temperatures, though, climbing back into the low 70s in many locations. So a nicer afternoon setting up. Temps will be slow to cool down this evening, even by 10 p.m., just dropping into the 50s here in Madison. Starting tomorrow morning, those clouds should begin to clear out, though. So more sunshine in our forecast for Monday. We'll be in the low 50s early tomorrow. Here's a look at that weekly forecast. Plan on mild temperatures through the week. Again, Monday will be dry. Rain developing later on Tuesday. Scattered showers and thunderstorms then Wednesday into Thursday. Humidity begins to build, though, and those temperatures climb into the 80s by the end of the week.
Thanks, Hattie. Nearly 200 gas stations every hour across the U.S. are returning to normal, but that's still not the case for the majority of spots here in the metro. This Quick Trip still has bags over all the pumps. It's a situation causing families to reconsider weekend plans. Sierra Cummings reports.
The fuel still running out.
We're tired of it.
The tempers still flaring up.
Like, I'm sick of this.
Federal officials hope this shortage is short-lived. Come Sunday, all is expected to be restored.
Cars ain't coming in because of the gas.
I don't even eat that.
Sitting at the BP on Abernathy Boulevard, Henry Mort normally sells 7 dozen bags of chips to folks at the pump. But this week, fewer drivers because of higher costs. Nearly $4 per regular gallon here.
But if they're not coming to get the gas,
let me get the ranch, babe.
You can't make no money.
Price plus the limited options, with 63% of metro stations still running on E, some won't be driving this weekend.
No, absolutely not. I'm not wasting any money. We don't know what the next surprise is.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna stay in because it's gas. Can't really afford it.
While a return appears to be merely 2 days away, Governor Brian Kemp has extended the state of emergency until May 22nd, just in case.
And coming up, Hattie has a look at our weekday forecast next on News 3 Now, this morning, Sunday.
First Warn Weather, certified most accurate forecast.
At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
Some days, you just don't have it. Not my uncle, though. He's taking Trulicity for his type 2 diabetes, and now he's really on his game.
Once weekly Trulicity lowers your A1C by helping your body release the insulin it's already making, most people reached an A1C under 7%. Plus, Trulicity can lower your risk of cardiovascular events. It can also help you lose up to 10 pounds. Trulicity is for type 2 diabetes. It isn't for people with type 1 diabetes. It's not approved for use in children. Don't take Trulicity if you're allergic to it, you or your family have medullary thyroid cancer, or have multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2. Stop Trulicity and call your doctor right away if you have an allergic reaction, a lump or swelling in your neck, severe stomach pain, changes in vision, or diabetic retinopathy. Serious side effects may include pancreatitis. Taking Trulicity with sulfonylurea or insulin raises low blood sugar risk. Side effects include nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, which can lead to dehydration and may worsen kidney problems. Show your world what's truly inside. Ask your doctor about once-weekly Trulicity.
Chevy is America's fastest-growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy and get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 models. That's over $4,700 cash back on this Equinox. Chevrolet, the number one selling brand in Wisconsin.
At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Well, lots of clouds to start your Sunday morning. A live look behind me here at the station. You can see the fog is lifting a little bit, which is good news, but still quite a few clouds in the area. No rain from these clouds right now, though. Temperatures statewide look like this. 55 here in Madison. In Green Bay, it's 53. Eau Claire is at 49, but Superior's a little cooler, still in the 30s this morning. Here's a look at our temperatures over the next 12 hours. We are going to climb back into the low 70s, so it'll feel much warmer today than it did yesterday. Coming up in a few minutes, we'll talk about that temperature trend going forward through the week.
Thanks, Hattie. Right now, we have some bittersweet news to share with everyone. Today is meteorologist Hattie McLean's last day with us here at News 3 Now. After 21 years of waking up early for the morning show, Hattie, we want to thank you for everything you've done for us and the community. Here's a look at some of the captured moments of Hattie's time here over the years. Let's take a look.
All right, guys, just sliding in and out of the camera frame this morning. It is clear ice. I don't have a chair. I can't possibly continue.
Charlotte's gonna help you.
I got it. I'm good. Look at this.
Switch.
We're in the stretch time.
Yeah. Time to tap dance.
Okay.
But it should be a pretty nice. Oh my gosh. A mouse just ran into the camera. Oh my God. So now I am prepared. I have a broom. Foley this morning. What was that?
What you got going on out there? That was a little, like kung fu action that you did right there.
Some sort of moth.
Mothra attacks!
Nice.
Oh God. It was that big. I mean, it was. Breathing fire will be pretty slow moving, so they have the potential to drop over an inch of rain in a short period of time. Oh my gosh. Moths as well outside this morning. I'm like being bombarded by bugs.
Mothra is back,
is
right?
Back. Yes. The west and parts of, what was that? I don't know what that was. That was Big Bird.
Did you in fact get pooped on? I think that's the real question.
Did
of the morning.
I? No, I don't think so.
Patty. Put him on for a minute.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
He's like, see what she looks like. See, it kind of matches your outfit.
It does.
You like it? The bling's
like
very nice.
Oh, I like that.
Very nice. Yeah, I need a belt buckle now.
Yeah, I'll work on that. See what I can do.
We'll wig something.
Thank you very much.
There you go. Perfect.
Winds stay fairly strong. During. Oh, my God.
They're coming after you.
Oh, I told you. I'm going to have to go to a witness protection program.
Am I on?
From the backyard weather patio. I'm on.
Whoa, best of Madison. Whoa, best of Madison.
And number one reason we love Hattie McLean,
number one reason
what?
We love Hattie's because she has a patio named after her.
Yay! That's why I couldn't call them at home. That is Hattie's family outside on the new patio. We're going to join them when we come right back. 73 in Rhinelander, 77 in Wausau. Lots of sunshine, though. I got to lose this. Current temperatures, 58. What? Are you kidding me? What is this?
I think that's your possum.
Run for your lives!
Always got to be on your toes when you show up at work, I guess. You can't beat them, join them, right?
I guess so. No other choice.
Well, decades of memories there. That's such a hoot.
Such a trip down memory lane. Do you see an animal trend with a lot of those clips?
I do.
Yeah, spent a lot of hours outside in the dark in the morning and was visited by many animals. So fun to watch all those clips. It's been an amazing two decades. Cannot believe all the things that have happened, all the things that have changed, but I've truly loved every minute of it. It's just been an honor to serve Southern Wisconsin.
Well, thank you, Hattie. We certainly appreciate you and everything you've done, keeping people safe in the weather and everything you do for us. So thank you. There's a half hour of news still ahead here on News 3 Now this morning, Sunday. Next, we're running through this morning's top stories.
I'm Gary Kenulty, inviting News 3 Now viewers to join me on an adventure to America's Northwest National Parks, August 9th through the 18th. Enjoy the natural wonders in beautiful Glacier, Yellowstone, and Grand Teton National Parks. Highlights include a boat tour through the gates of the mountains and a Bar T5 covered wagon cookout. Visit holidayvacations.com, keyword WISC, for information on how you can attend a virtual travel show or call 888-557-1020 for a free brochure.
Summer's here, and with a great deal on a new Toyota, you can go out and do all the things that make summer, well, summer. Like go biking, glamping, pony rides, Mother's Day, scavenger hunts.
Found it!
Off-roading!
Right now, you can lease a new 2021 Benza Hybrid for just $269 a month. To learn more, visit your local Toyota dealer or go to toyota.com.
Your summer starts here.
Toyota, let's go places.
The light at the end of the tunnel isn't shining so brightly for everyone. Families continue to fight for survival. Some jobs are gone forever. Bills pile up. But please know, you have not been forgotten. Your local Wisconsin Energy and Emergency Rental Assistance providers are working together to keep you safely in your home and your heat and power on. Apply now for a hand up.
Whether you live in a house or a high-rise, protect it with fire sprinklers. Fire sprinklers buy time. Time buys life. Learn more at firesprinklersbylife.com.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Attacks on Asian Americans continue across the country as hate crimes rise here in Wisconsin. Where does this hatred come from, and how can you be part of the solution? I'm getting to the root of the issue. On For the Record, this morning at 10:30.
I'm News 3 Now's Josh Spreider. I'm visiting the people, places, and events that make this area one of a kind. Tell me what inspires you, and it might be featured on News 3 Now this morning.
In the 608, weekdays on News 3 Now this morning.
Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenulty here. If your TV or internet goes out during severe weather, the Midland Weather Radio can be the extra measure of safety you and your family need. Pick up the Midland Weather Radio, available now at area Hy-Vee grocery stores.
This is News 3 Now this morning.
Good morning. It's Sunday, May 16th. I'm Gabriella Becerra. Let's check in with meteorologist Hattie McLean with your Sunday morning forecast.
And good morning, Gabrielle, and good morning to all of you. I have better news. Today is going to be warmer than yesterday. Take a look at the high temperatures yesterday across the area. Some spots west of Dane County didn't even make it into the 60s, just 61 here in Madison. That was almost 10 degrees cooler than what we normally would be this time of the year. A live look outside. The fog is starting to lift, seeing just a little bit of blue sky outside, but plenty of clouds. Here's a look at those current visibility numbers. Again, some big improvement back up to visibility better than 3 miles in southwestern Wisconsin. Just a mile and three quarters, though, in the Dells, about 2.5 miles in Juneau. But looks like that fog is finally starting to lift. Our temperatures are in the mid-50s in most spots. In fact, we're 55 here in Madison, 54 in Juneau. Through southwestern Wisconsin, temperatures in the mid-50s as well. So a nice mild start to the day. And even despite quite a few clouds, winds will be from the south, and temperatures are going to climb back into the low 70s later on this afternoon. So quite a bit warmer than it was yesterday. Again, coming up in a few minutes, we do have a nice temperature trend in that extended forecast. We'll talk about warming numbers.
Thanks, Hattie. 4 months after a number of Rockhaven nursing home employees were laid off for refusing to take a vaccine, they and their attorney are continuing to fight back. Fitchburg attorney Michael Anderson tells News 3 Now he had filed a $500,000 notice of claim against Rock County. Anderson says this is a precursor to an actual lawsuit. He's hoping the county will enter into a dialogue with him and they'll be able to come to a resolution without going to court.
There are people out there that would still look at my clients and say, why in the world, you know, aren't you getting vaccinated? I want people to recognize that these are still non-fully FDA approved drugs. And we're in a unique time, but for something that is an emergency use authorized drug, the law says that you can't force somebody to do that.
The county has 120 days to respond to the notice of claim. The Middleton Police Department is committing to hiring 30% sworn female officers by 2030. It's part of the National 30 by 30 initiative, which aims to bring more women into policing to improve public safety, community outcomes, and trust in law enforcement. Middleton Police Chief Troy Hellenbrand says 18% of the city's officers right now are women. Before leaving his post this month, former Dane County Sheriff Dave Mahoney had the sheriff's office joined the national project as well. A porch fire in Janesville left an estimated $100,000 in damages Saturday morning. Authorities responded to Wilson Avenue around 3:30 after a fire was started on a porch and later extended into the house and to a car parked nearby. A man and two children inside the home made it out safely. Officials say one firefighter suffered a minor injury. As the temperature ticks up, so does the number of people out on the local lakes. The Clean Lakes Alliance is preparing for its busiest time of the year, but it can't do so without the help of nearly 100 volunteers. Christina Laurie tells us about the program, helping keep our community's biggest resource ready to use all summer long.
What a treasure these lakes are.
Lake season is here, and the Clean Lakes Alliance is getting ready to launch its eighth year of volunteer monitoring, a program unique to Madison.
It's probably one of the largest in the country, if not one of two largest in the world.
From Memorial to Labor Day weekend, nearly 100 volunteers test 75 points on Madison's five biggest lakes twice a week.
Test their site for clarity, the water temperature, if there's any visual, if they see a cyanobacteria bloom or something like that.
After many tests and many numbers,
the information it's shared with Public Health Madison Dane County. We share it with the DNR. We use their beach information, opening, closing, and it's all pulled into Lake Forecast.
Lake Forecast is a free app where all that data is simplified and shared.
If you're planning a lake day, you know, hey, maybe it looks like things are a little murky over at Governor Nelson, but they look really good at James Madison.
And in anticipation of another busy season out on the water,
it's almost like checking the weather in the morning.
Monitoring kicks off 1 week from Thursday. In Madison, Christina Laurie, News 3 Now.
This is also the time of the year when the phrase blue-green algae often pops up. The Clean Lakes Alliance is still figuring out what that will look like. The good news is the snow melted slowly and the spring has mostly been dry. So right now the Alliance is hopeful for a good lake season. Wisconsin is known for its milk and cheese, and the Badgerland Girl Scouts are hoping they can grow some dairy lovers and dairy workers. The Girl Scouts debuted Wisconsin's first Badgerland Dairy Patch Saturday. The patch will help educate middle school and high school girls about the diverse range range of dairy-related professions available at the event in Dane Saturday morning. The Girl Scouts got a chance to work with interactive dairy stations and examined a real cow with a stethoscope and ultrasound.
Kind of reaching an age where I'm starting to think about what I maybe want to do when I'm older, and this is a great way, I feel like, to be exposed, you know, to more careers and opportunities that might be possible for me.
Agriculture is so cool, and I think people, because they don't have the grandparents' farm to go to anymore, they don't even think about a career choice in agriculture, and especially in dairy, and it is so wide open and so amazing.
The new patch is being piloted in Dane County. Leaders hope it will be a statewide opportunity for Girl Scouts next year. Stay with us. More News 3 after this.
Hey, Hats. It's been such a pleasure working with you all these years. I'm going to miss you so much. On to bigger and better things.
This is a giant eyesore.
All you have to do is point.
When you want junk to disappear, all you have to do is point.
Chevy is America's fastest growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy and get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 Chevy SUV models, or get a $4,000 cash allowance on all 2021 Silverado 1500 True Cab pickups.
Dun, dun, dun. I'll make a whisk and make them bounce. Quiet on your lips, come make that sound. Drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it. You gotta work it, work it, work it, work it, work it.
Ready to Juvederm it? Correct age-related volume loss in cheeks with Juvederm Voluma XC. Add fullness to lips with Juvederm Ultra XC. And smooth moderate to severe lines around the nose and mouth with Juvederm XC. Tell your doctor if you have a history of scarring or are taking medicines that decrease the body's immune response or that can prolong bleeding. Common side effects include injection site redness, swelling, pain, tenderness, firmness, lumps, bumps, bruising, discoloration, or itching. As with all fillers, there is a rare risk of unintentional injection into a blood vessel, which can cause vision abnormalities, blindness, stroke, temporary scabs, or scarring. Juvederm. Talk to your doctor about the Juvederm collection of fillers.
Oh, baby, are you going my way? I see you kicking off for hours a day, so baby, don't know you at all. I'm not crazy or a fiend. Not stop the energy.
Down your money with security from Chase. Control feels good. Chase, make more of what's yours.
I've lost count of how many asthma attacks I've had, but my new normal with Nucala, fewer asthma attacks.
Nucala is a once-monthly add-on injection for severe eosinophilic asthma, not for sudden breathing problems. Allergic reactions can occur. Get help right away for swelling of face, mouth, tongue, or trouble breathing. Infections that can cause shingles have occurred. Don't stop steroids unless told by your doctor. Tell your doctor if you have a parasitic infection. May cause headache, injection site reactions, back pain, and fatigue. Ask your doctor about Nucala.
Find your new normal with Nucala.
It's that time of year again.
How can we help? Could you haul this away for me? Oh, it's gone. There was stuff here. Amazing.
When you want junk to disappear, all you have to do is point.
And it's about 7:30 this morning. We did have some patchy fog earlier this morning, but it's now starting to lift. Even a few breaks in the cloud cover here in southern Wisconsin. Not a lot of not very many breaks in the cloud cover in southwestern Wisconsin, though. Here's a live look from our Queen Bee Radio Sky Camera in Platteville. The clouds are lifting, but still low clouds pretty prevalent in the area. Visibility has improved in most spots, just a couple of areas with visibility less than 3 miles right now. Temperatures have been pretty steady under those low clouds all night. 55 here in Madison. In the Dells, it's 52, but Camp Douglas starts at 54 and Platteville's at 55. As you head out the door this morning, just be aware of that little bit of fog still lingering, but otherwise expect a warmer day. Temperatures are going to make it back into the low 70s this afternoon with variably cloudy skies.
Thanks, Hattie. The Wisconsin Film Festival is taking place this week with a virtual format. The week-long festival includes some films made right here in Wisconsin. Our photojournalist Chris Hawbaker talked to the two Golden Badger Award-winning directors and gives us a preview.
The question seems simple, but the answer's kind of long.
I'm literally the only person I know that plays hockey. That's an African-Canadian.
Nuclear Gopher was a record label and online community of Jehovah's Witnesses who all did indie music.
The Wisconsin Film Festival has always been really important to me. It's the place where I sort of discovered what a film could be. The Passing On is a film about the oldest African-American funeral home in San Antonio.
Everybody want to do their own thing now. I mean, we need some young people.
I think at the most basic level, it's an awareness and an appreciation of sort of the legacy of the Black funeral home. I was born in Madison. I lived there for, that's really where I began my film career. Just to be sort of included in the festival is really remarkable for me and a real honor.
When I first started going to the festival as an attendee, I was nervous because I was like, this place might be too cool for me. It's nice to see the occasional art film, but I don't really want to work that hard when I'm watching a movie.
Wir sind nach Paris gekommen.
This festival doesn't only show sort of classy foreign films with subtitles. It shows goofy, funny, entertaining stuff, but maybe not the same goofy, entertaining stuff that you're gonna find elsewhere.
At times it's like crazy.
The film is about Jasmine Ferries, who's a 32-year-old who happens to have Down syndrome. And every summer she writes and directs a play that her family and friends perform. The characters in the play are all of her celebrity obsessions. So she's married to Matthew McConaughey, but she has an affair with Mark Wahlberg.
The Wisconsin Zone program is near and dear to my heart. All we ask is that the film or the filmmaker have some tie to Wisconsin. Either the filmmaker was born here or the film features the state somewhere in the film.
The pundits talking about Wisconsin, they mentioned Green Bay.
Film festivals have always been places where you can be exposed to sort of new and different ways of telling stories, filmmakers from different places that you're not going to experience on Netflix or Amazon, especially when they have access to your watch history and are only giving you stuff they already think you want to watch.
If we could have done it in person, I think I'd be really worried right now. We'll get them next year. We're like the Bad News Bears.
And the Wisconsin Film Festival is happening all week until Thursday. You can check that out at wifilmfest.org. Tickets are available, and you can figure out how to get passes online. A very special prom for students in Illinois. 18 schools in the Noble Charter System experienced prom at Soldier Field Friday night. Soldier Field is home to the Chicago Bears and the city's soccer team, the Chicago Fire. About 1,000 kids were in attendance Friday, and 1,000 more got their proms on Saturday. Noble Charter School CEO says the last year has been challenging, and they were happy to provide students with the opportunity to celebrate. Students were able to take photos all over the field, and some of them were even shown on the Jumbotron. Delaware State University students got an unexpected graduation gift this week. The university announced Wednesday it's using the funds it received from the American Rescue Plan to reduce student debt. Delaware State awarded $730,000 in debt relief to recent graduates facing financial hardship. A total of 223 students each received about $3,300. For some students, it made the difference in whether or not they could graduate. Delaware State administrators say it's the least they could do for the graduates in this uncertain time. Someone out there may become a multimillionaire Friday night. The Mega Millions jackpot is now at $430 million. According to the lottery, this is only the second time it has surpassed the $400 million mark. during the month of May. The jackpot has been rolling since the last time someone won February 16th. You've got a better chance of doing just about anything else in the universe, including being admitted into the emergency room with a pogo stick related injury. But still, millions of people, that tiny shred of hope appears to be worth the price of admission. We'll be right back after this.
Hattie, I am so lucky to have called you a coworker over these last 7 years, but what's even more special is the friendship that we have developed. Over the last 3 years that we've been on the morning show together, I have learned from you, I've laughed with you, and I know that that isn't over. You might be saying goodbye to News 3 today, but you're not saying goodbye to the rest of us. I know we have plenty of laughs in store for the future. We love you, Hattie.
And if you have a little kid turning 3 soon, please let us know so we can show their picture on TV.
Look Who's 3 is sponsored by Three Bears Resort, Indoor Water Park and Conference Center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
This is a Wisconsin farmer. She grows the locally sourced freshness, the freshness that complements the wild-caught salmon, the salmon that tees up the cheesecake that sweetens every moment. Festival Foods, we are Wisconsin.
You know this guy?
With the most standard safety features in its class.
Nice stop, Mom.
Thanks. The fiercely reimagined Nissan Rogue. Get a low 219 per month lease on Rogue or get 0% financing for up to 72 months on 14 models.
The ups and downs of frequent mood swings can take you to deep depressive lows or give you unusually high energy even when depressed. Overwhelmed by bipolar 1? Ask about Vraylar. Some medicines only treat the lows or highs. Vraylar effectively treats depression, acute manic, and mixed episodes of bipolar 1 in adults. Full spectrum relief for all bipolar 1 symptoms with just one pill once a day. Elderly patients with dementia-related psychosis have an increased risk of death or stroke. Call your doctor about unusual changes in behavior or suicidal thoughts. Antidepressants can increase these in children and young adults. Report fever, stiff muscles, or confusion, which may mean a life-threatening reaction, or uncontrollable muscle movements, which may be permanent. Side effects may not appear for several weeks. High cholesterol and weight gain, high blood sugar, which can lead to coma or death, may occur. Movement dysfunction, sleepiness, and stomach issues are common side effects. When bipolar 1 overwhelms, Vraylar helps smooth the ups and downs.
My retirement plan with Voya keeps me moving forward. They guide me with achievable steps that give me confidence. This is my granddaughter. She's cute like her grandpa. Voya doesn't just help me get to retirement, they're with me all the way through it.
Voya, be confident to and through retirement.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
This is a Wisconsin brewmaster. He brews the local craft beer. The beer that washes down the Oktoberfest brat. The brat that pairs with the potato salad. The potato salad that befriends the burger. The burger that tastes like victory. Festival Foods. We are Wisconsin.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
And just about 7:45 this morning, we're talking about a nice warm-up in that extended forecast. In fact, take a look at the CPC 8 to 14 day temperature outlook, and it indicates that we have a pretty good chance for above normal temperatures through the midsection of the country, better chance for above normal temperatures through the mid-Atlantic region. But again, a nice warm-up in store in our forecast. Take a look at high temperatures yesterday. A little cool here across southern Wisconsin yesterday with highs only in the low 60s. You didn't have to go far though for 70s, 72 in Des Des Moines yesterday, mid to upper 70s through the central plains. So that heat that's building out to the west is going to be allowed to move eastward over the next couple of days, and we'll see a nice warming trend with our temperatures as well. Now, there is some precipitation to talk about, but it's well off to our west this morning in the Dakotas and Nebraska. Is kind of a wet start this morning. Some showers and thunderstorms breaking out along this warm front that will eventually lift northward, but with high pressure in control right now, that warm front is going to be slow to make northward progress. So we'll squeeze out another day or two with dry weather here across southern Wisconsin. A lot of clouds in place, but not a very good chance for rain today. Our current conditions, cloudy skies, 55 here in Madison. Winds are calm. Dew point is in the mid-50s. Kind of a big jump from yesterday at this time where dew points were in the 30s. So we're definitely starting to see an increase in the moisture in the atmosphere. Mid-50s really across the map this morning. The exception would be the Dells. You're at 52 degrees this morning, but everyone else starting off pretty mild. Our winds are calm right now. They will be from the south, though, and that'll allow us to warm up a little bit more today. Take a look at your future track forecast model. You'll note a lot of clouds in place early today, and while there may be a few breaks here and there, clouds are going to continue through the day for southern Wisconsin. Temperatures, though, are going to warm by lunchtime. Already warmer than we were yesterday. There's that chance for an isolated shower popping up this afternoon, but most areas staying dry. Take a look at the high temperatures, though. 72 here in Madison, 71 in Lone Rock, 70 in Monroe, 73 today in Janesville. Temps will be slow to cool down this evening with clouds still lingering, only dropping into the 50s at 10 p.m. Here's a look at that extended forecast then. I mentioned a nice warm-up. We do have 80s in the forecast, more summertime humidity as well as we head through the week, and some chances for rain. We definitely need it here across southern Wisconsin. Best chance coming late Tuesday into Wednesday.
Thank you, Hattie. Medications may not be the best way to treat insomnia and a major step in returning to life without masks. Elise Preston has some of the week's top health stories.
Fully vaccinated people are allowed to stop wearing masks outdoors in crowds and in most indoor settings. That's according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. The latest guidance still calls for wearing masks in crowded indoor settings like buses, planes, and hospitals. About 120 million people are fully vaccinated in the U.S. Long-term use of prescription medications for insomnia does not appear to help middle-aged women get better quality sleep. U.S. researchers looked at nearly 700 women over 2 years and found no difference in sleep quality or amount of sleep between women who took medications and those who didn't. And for children with recurrent ear infections, a study finds no long-term benefit to having tubes surgically placed in the eardrum. Research in the New England Journal of Medicine says using oral antibiotics is just as effective and avoids the risks of anesthesia and surgery. Those are some of the week's top health stories. Elise Preston, CBS News, New York.
People who visit Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, no longer have to wear masks outdoors. The park says it's still requiring them inside shops and restaurants. Visitors also have to wear masks from when they line up for a ride until they exit it. As for social distancing, Universal is trying to keep guests 3 feet apart. A number of different incentives are being offered in the push to achieve widespread coronavirus vaccination in the U.S. Things being given away, including lottery tickets, beer, French fries, and now ice cream. That's right, ice cream is being used to sweeten the pot and battle vaccine hesitancy. Unilever giving away free popsicles and Klondike shakes to healthcare workers and people getting vaccinated at several sites across the U.S. Unilever owns Klondike, Breyers, Ben & Jerry's, and a bunch of other brands. The first known COVID-to-COVID double lung transplant recipient is sharing his amazing story with the world. Renato Aquino went to the hospital a year ago, suffering from shortness of breath due to COVID-19. The virus ultimately caused permanent lung damage, and he spent the next 12 months out in and out of hospitals, wondering if the end was near. But a donor became available, and Aquino's lung transplant was done on February 25th by Northwestern Medicine. The lungs came from a donor who also had COVID, but had recovered before dying of an unrelated cause and had not suffered permanent lung damage. Make News 3 Now part of your weekly routine by downloading the Channel 3000 app for the latest headlines and weather conditions 24/7.
Hi, Hattie.
everybody. Just want to say I feel so lucky that we got a chance to work together in Madison. One of my fondest memories obviously involves one of our many morning potlucks, and I think it was my last day when you brought homemade key lime pie yogurt, and I'd been eating the store-bought stuff for months and months and months, and I just thought it was so sweet and thoughtful that you learned how to whip it up for us. So just want to say thank you for always being a friendly face and a ray of sunshine on those early mornings. Sending you best wishes on your next adventure and very big hugs. So, see ya.
At Wild East Town Honda, lease a new all-wheel drive CR-V with sunroof for $309. That's $309 and absolutely zero due at signing. At Wild East Town Honda in Madison, it's gotta be wild.
Small town, you grow up a little different.
When U.S. Cellular's founder Roy Carlson looked at small towns, he saw nothing but potential that deserved the best technology. Since the other guys were busy with the biggest cities, well, he'd just have to build a network there himself. Here's the thing, when you create a network as a local, you know the dead spots, so you fix them. You know the neighbors, so you're good to them. Did you drop these? You know the local neighborhood, so you make a difference.
Thanks for the hot spot.
When you go town by town doing it different, you might even win some awards. You might even want to celebrate. But we're still far from done. You know, it's a good thing we started local. Otherwise, we might not be a little different. The nationwide network built from your town up. U.S. Cellular.
People today, they could spend half their lives over 50. So it helps to have a wise friend and fierce defender like AARP to help you take control of your health along the way.
What's in it?
I don't know, but it's green.
Green's good.
Whether it's your wellness.
What are you in for?
Cholesterol check.
Cool.
Your brain health.
Yeah. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Or your endurance. That's why the younger you are, the more you need AARP. Join today.
No one sells more. Wild Automotive sells more SUVs and all-wheel drives combined than any other dealer. Wild is the number one volume SUV and all-wheel drive retailer in Southeast Wisconsin. The more we sell, the more you save. WildAuto.com.
News 3 Now is your vaccine information headquarters. Every day, we go the extra mile to provide the vital information you need about COVID-19 vaccination.
This is a life-saving vaccine.
This month, we went even further by hosting a vaccine clinic to make it convenient for anyone who wanted a shot.
It's really important for us to be able to help get our Latinx community vaccinated.
And we will continue to take action to make sure the vaccine is available to everyone. News 3 Now, your vaccine information headquarters.
You often hear about your local news weather team, but in Minneapolis, Fox 9 KMSP meteorologist Jennifer McDermott is her own team. She was giving her forecast Tuesday night when her on-screen graphics glitched, causing her to multiply across the screen in what she called a funhouse-like situation, creating a whole clan of Jennifer McDermott's mirroring her every move. She says it took all of her willpower to finish her forecast through the laughter. And we have our own special meteorologist here at News 3 Now, and right now we want to celebrate and thank her. Hattie has been with News 3 Now for over 21 years. We're sad to see her go, but we'll always remember the wonderful moments, the professionalism, and the care she has for you, the viewer. It's never goodbye, but always see you later. Here's a look at some of the captured moments of her time over the years. Let's take a look.
All right, guys, just sliding in and out of the camera frame this morning. It is glare ice. I can't possibly continue.
Charlotte's going to help you.
I got it. I'm good. Look at this. Switch. We're in the stretch time.
Yeah. Time to tap dance. Okay.
But it should be a pretty nice. Oh my gosh.
a mouse just ran into the camera. Oh, my God.
So now I am prepared. I have a broom. Foley this morning.
What you got going on out there? That was a little, like kung fu action that you did right there.
Some sort of moth.
Mothra attacks! Ah!
Nice.
Oh, God. It was that big. I mean, it was,
there was a
breathing fire. Will be pretty slow moving, so they have the potential to drop over an inch of rain in a short period of time. Oh, my gosh. Moths as well outside this morning. I'm, like, being bombarded. By bugs.
Mothra is back,
is
right?
Back, yes. The west and parts of, what was that? I don't know what that was. That was Big Bird.
Did you, in fact, get pooped on? I think
no.
That's the real question.
Did
of the morning.
I? No, I don't think so.
Patty. Put him on for a minute.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah,
he's like, see what she looks like. See, it kind of matches your outfit.
It does.
You like it? The bling's
yeah, like
very
yeah.
nice.
Oh, I like that.
Very
nice.
Yeah, I need like the belt buckle now.
Yeah, I'll work on that.
Yeah.
See what I can do.
Okay,
we'll wig something.
Thank you very much. There you go. Perfect.
Wednesday fairly strong. During. Oh, my God.
They're coming after you.
Oh, I told you. I'm going to have to go on a witness protection program.
Light on.
From the backyard weather patio. I'm on.
Whoa, best of Madison. Whoa, best of Madison.
And number one reason we love Hattie McLean.
Number one reason
what?
We love Hattie is because she has a patio named after her.
Yay! That's why I couldn't call them at home. That is Hattie's family outside on the new patio. We're going to join them when we come right back.
73 in Rhinelander, 77 in Wausau. Lots of sunshine, though. I got to lose this.
Oh,
55 in
Wausau.
Current temperatures, 58. What? Are you kidding me? What is this?
I think that's your possum.
Run for your lives.
Possum. Always got to be on your toes when you show up at work, I guess.
So
you can't
you
beat
doing?
Them, join them, right?
I guess so. No other choice.
So many memories,
I know.
Gabrielle.
Decades. I can only hope that I have a career as great as yours.
Oh, I've been so lucky to work in one spot for so long and meet so many nice people. I've truly enjoyed getting to know the viewers. And as you can see from that clip, we just had a lot of laughs. It was so fun. Even though we were waking up at the before the sun got up, we just had so much fun on the show. And that I'll always remember that. Love all those animal adventures. See my kids pop on there. I can't believe how young they look. Now they're all taller than me right now. But I am truly thankful for the time that I had here and just looking forward to the next adventure. I'll be smashing my alarm clock later today.
Well, certainly we are so thankful for you. And right now we actually have some breaking news. There are reports of a large crowd gathering outside on the Hattie patio.
Are you serious?
Hattie, we're on the Hattie-O patio here. We've got a few friends of yours behind us.
Oh my gosh, look at all those faces. Well, I can't wait to come out and say hi to all of you guys. Thank you so much for showing up.
Well, you know, Rob Starbuck is here. Eileen, we've got Adam Schrager, so we've got everybody back here. So, but Hattie, I'd just like to thank you for your 21 years of service here. It's been a pleasure to work with you. You've worked on all the shifts with me at some point during your career, but. You know, now's the time to relax. You can come out here and have a good time with us. But you still have to finish the show. But you know, as soon as you're done, you can come on out. So
of course,
I'll put
never
you to work
hanging.
For at least a couple more minutes. So.
Oh my gosh, thank you guys. You know, I said I'm like no crying today, no crying. But boy, it's gonna be tough to make it through that without a tear. But thank you so much. It's been an amazing run.
Yeah, you're very welcome. And like I say, you got a bunch of friends out here ready to say hello. Dana's been cooking bacon here, so we're gonna have a great time. You'll be able to relax here for a little bit. So again, thank you for your years of service for us here at News 3 Now. And again, we wish you the best of luck in the future. And don't be a stranger to us either. Otherwise, we'll have to put you to work.
We love you, Hattie. All right, thank you. Well, out, so it's going to be a great day today. Enjoy high temperatures in the 70s.